Get this and get it straight. Crime is a sucker's road, and those who travel it wind up in the gutter, the prison of the grave. This started with a man on trial for his life and an A1 citizen eager to testify. But there it was interrupted. And it wasn't until I found a corpse in a bubbling bath, gunplay in the woods, and lots of blackmail that the real eager witness had a chance to talk.
From the pen of Raymond Chandler, outstanding author of mystery, comes his most famous character and crime's most deadly enemy as we present The Adventures of Philip Marlowe. Now, with Gerald Mohr, starred as Philip Marlowe, we bring you tonight's exciting story, The Eager Witness.
Division 88 of the Superior Court of the State of California and for the County of Los Angeles now in session. The Honorable Albert Winston, judge presiding. Everybody rise.
It was the case of the people versus the oft-arrested, never-convicted, smooth Earl Jernigan, sometimes Bookie, charged in the first degree with a month-old killing of a kindly, gray-haired horse trainer named Kurt Hopper, who had once almost been my client. It was the afternoon of the fourth day of the trial, and the prosecutor for the state had already built an almost airtight case against the alleged gambler when my turn finally came.
To further substantiate the state's claim that Earl Jernigan did willfully and with malice aforethought take the life of the deceased Kurt Hopper. Will Mr. Philip Marlowe take the stand?
Raise your right hand. Promise to tell truth, the whole truth, nothing but truth, help you God.
I do.
State your name and occupation.
Philip Marlowe, private detective.
Take stand.
Mr. Marlowe, on the morning of the 30th day of July last, the day on which the late Kurt Hopper was murdered, were you hired as a private detective by the said Mr. Hopper?
I was.
And at that time, Mr. Marlowe, did Mr. Hopper state his reason for hiring you?
He did. He wanted me to act as his personal bodyguard on the following day when he planned to drive to San Francisco.
Did he say why he needed a personal bodyguard?
He did. He told me he was afraid for his life, that he refused the gambler's demand that he drug a certain racehorse a week earlier, that gambler had threatened to kill him.
I see. Now, Mr. Marlowe, did Mr. Hopper name that gambler?
Yes, he did.
Who was it?
Earl Jernigan.
Thank you. No further questions, Your Honor.
Counsel for the defense?
Counsel for the defense waives cross-examination, Your Honor.
The witness is excused.
Didn't make sense. No cross-examination. Because from the opening adjective, the counsel for the defense, a dapper item named Calder, who always appeared in French cuffs, gray gabardine, and a cocky, uninviting smile, had raved, ranted, and practically spit at each witness the state had presented. So the courtroom was left with a tingling impression that Earl Jernigan's attorney had something of a surprise waiting up his legal sleeve. Later, when Calder was on his feet and addressing the jury, that something started out fast.
Now that the state has taken the trouble to offer so much circumstantial evidence, so much hearsay, rumor, conjecture, now will I smash all of that with the testimony of one man. One man known to all of you as an outstanding citizen of this city. A prominent real estate broker. An unimpeachable witness eager to testify. Mr. Leonard Gaines.
It worked. Landed in each and every lap like a live grenade and exploded all the way around at once. And when the eminent Mr. Gaines, gray at the temples, maybe 45, a neat and expensive midnight blue flannel with giant stick pin to match, took the stand, and in his own meeting of the board tone of voice, told the court that Earl Jernigan had spent the entire day and night of July 30th last with him at his Malibu Beach home, the prosecuting attorney's jaw dropped to his chest and he stared dumb.
No time during that day or night did Mr. Jernigan ever leave my home. And as for the hour of the murder, 8 o'clock in the evening, we were having dinner. After that, we played gin rummy until midnight.
Are you sure of that, Mr. Gaines? The hour of your dinner, I mean.
I am positive, Mr. Calder.
No, you can't be. You're lying.
Quiet, quiet in the court.
Order, Miss Harper. Order in the court, please.
No, I won't be quiet. I won't anymore.
Miss Harper, quiet.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.